Hello my dear friends, I am Professor YM Khan and this is the part 3 of unit number 2, block diagram and signal flow graph of subject automatic control system. Now in last video we have studied block diagram reduction and the algebra related with the reduction of blocks in case of the series connection, parallel connection and feedback connection. So today we'll see some more algebra regarding this block diagram reduction, and in today's video we will see how to reduce the or how to apply algebra on summing points and takeoff points. Now before proceeding to that, I'll request you to subscribe to my channel, like this video and share this video. Let us begin. Now whenever we are seeing a summing point in a block diagram, that means summing point is a point where at which number of inputs come together and there is one output of that summing point. So the coming inputs may be positive, may be negative, but there is only one output from this summing point, and that summing point is represented with a circle with a cross, right? So there are two possibilities. Now in block diagram algebra for summing points, there are two possibilities of shifting this summing point with respect to blocks. Okay, now we can shift this summing point, okay, after the block. If it is present before the block, we can shift this summing point after the block, and if this summing point is present before the block, then we can if the summing point is after the block, then we can shift this summing point before the block. So whatever the position of the block of the summing point may be, we can shift it either before the block or we can shift it either after the block. Now see what kind of arrangements need to be done in the above two cases one by one. So let us see first case of shifting summing point after the block. Here in this diagram you can see that the summing point is present before the block. Okay, now this summing point is having some input and there is one output with respect to this inputs. Okay, there are multiple inputs here. So like this, RS is there, X of S is there, and we are getting RS plus R of S and plus X of S as a output, as an output of this summing point. Now since this summing point is present before the block, we can shift, if we want to, we can shift this block, this summing point after the block. ओके, हम क्या कर सकते हैं इस समिंग पॉइंट को, जैसे ये ब्लॉक के पहले है तो इस ब्लॉक के बाद में हम क्या कर सकते हैं, इस समिंग पॉइंट को शिफ्ट कर सकते हैं. जब आप इस समिंग पॉइंट को एक ब्लॉक के बाद में शिफ्ट करेंगे, सो बट ऑब्वियस है कि जो उसका एलजेब्रा है वो चेंज हो जाएगा, बिकॉज यहाँ पर आर ऑफ एस प्लस एक्स ऑफ एस हमारा आउटपुट है समिंग पॉइंट का. अगर उसको इधर शिफ्ट किया जाए तो यहाँ पर तो ऑलरेडी एक आउटपुट प्रेजेंट है वाई ऑफ एस, तो इसकी वजह से क्या इम्पैक्ट आएगा, या इस आर ऑफ एस प्लस एक्स ऑफ एस या इस समिंग पॉइंट को इधर शिफ्ट करने की वजह से इस वाई ऑफ एस पे क्या इम्पैक्ट आएगा, ये हमको स्टडी करना है. ओके, सो द समिंग पॉइंट हैज़ टू इनपुट्स आर ऑफ एस एंड एक्स ऑफ एस, देयरफॉर इट्स आउटपुट इज आर ऑफ एस प्लस एक्स ऑफ एस. इन फर्दर वीडियोज आई विल यूज आर एस एंड एक्स एस. ओके, सो दैट इट गेट्स सिंपलर, सिंपल फॉर अस टू अंडरस्टैंड. ओके, नाउ सो द इनपुट, देयरफॉर द इनपुट फॉर दिस जीएस ब्लॉक और दिस ब्लॉक इज आर एस प्लस एक्सएस, वेयर एज द आउटपुट ऑफ दिस जीएस ब्लॉक इज वाई एस. ओके, और यू कैन से वाई ऑफ एस. सो ऑल ऑफ यू नो द फॉर्मूला फॉर आउटपुट. यस, द फॉर्मूला फॉर आउटपुट इज योर गेन मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द इनपुट, और ट्रांसफर फंक्शन मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द इनपुट. सो आर ऑफ एस प्लस एक्स ऑफ एस होल ब्रैकेट मल्टीप्लाइड बाय जी एस इज इक्वल्स टू वाई ऑफ एस. सो दिस इज योर से इक्वेशन नंबर 1. This is your equation number 1. Okay, so GS will be multiplied to RS plus it will also be multiplied to XS. So G of S multiplied by R of S plus G of S multiplied by X of S. So this is equation number 1. This is now the original you can say output of the system, or it is the original output of this block diagram. We want to maintain this original output. Okay, now let us shift the summing point after the block. So we have shifted this summing point here. Now the input which is associated with this summing point, that is your X of S, will also be shifted with it. Okay, because this is your original input, so the original input will remain as it is. This is the another reference input, so this reference input will be shifted to this point because we are shifting the summing point here. Now we'll shift this summing point here. Okay, now let us again concentrate on the block. Now the input for block is R of S, therefore its output is G of S multiplied by R of S. Now if you consider only this block, okay, in this figure, in the previous figure, its output was Y of S and its value was GS multiplied by RS plus GS multiplied by XS. Okay, but here it is totally changed. Now we want to maintain the original input. We just want to shift the summing point so as to reduce the efforts required to reduce the diagram. We want to simplify the diagram, that's why we are only shifting this on the right hand side, or you can say after the block. Okay, so G of S and R of S is your into G of S into R of S is your output of this block. Now this output is given to the summing point as a input, as an input, and we have the previous input to this summing point X of S. Now if you see, if you observe the output of this summing point, it is again Y of S. Okay, it is Y of S and is equals to G of S plus R of S plus X of S. Now this is your equation number 2. Now let us compare these equations. This is your equation number 1, which says Y of S is equals to GS RS plus GS XS, and equation number 2 says YS is equals to GS plus RS, GS into RS plus XS. Now if you compare this equation number 1 and equation number 2 with each other, both says Y of S, yes, but the first term here, G of S plus G of S and multiplied by R of S, is same in both equation, but the second term after the plus sign is different. Here G of S is missing in equation number 2, but our target is to maintain this G of S here in equation number 2 also. Okay, now to maintain, to do such thing, we have to make some changes. We have to improvise the diagram. Okay, now this diagram is having X of S input, okay, and your output is dependent on these both things. Now this G of S and R of S cannot be changed because it is the output of the block, okay, and it is dependent on RS. So you have to make changes here, then the respective values will get changed. And also this G of S and R of S is a common term in both the equations, so you do not need to change this side, but you will need to change on this another side. Okay, now in order to get the second term also same, we require one more G of S here. So what will we do? Yes, the input here given to summing point in the modified diagram or in this diagram is X of S, so you need to add GS to it. So how will you add GS to it? You just need one block in between this XS and summing point. Now if you add GS block in between them, so your output of this GS block will become XS multiplied by GS, as all of you know that the output of a block is gain multiplied by input. So your gain is g of s multiplied by x of s. Okay. So you get output as per our requirement. Now if you see y of s now in this particular diagram, it becomes gsrs plus gsxs, because at summing point both the inputs are getting added. We are performing summation operation here. Okay, so gs plus gsrs plus gsxs. Now if you compare this new equation, it is similar to the equation number one. So that means our output, the original output, is now same. Okay, although we have shifted this summing point on the right side of the block, or you can say after the block, and we have made changes, but the output of the system is again same. So that means you have successfully shifted the summing point after the block without changing the output. Okay, so your output again becomes GSRS plus GSXS. Okay, this is about shifting the block, shifting the summing point after the block. Okay, let us think on another point, that is your shifting summing point before the block. Jo summing point after the block hai, usko kya karna hai humko? Before the block lagana hai. Okay, now here the output of this block diagram is y of s, which is again dependent on this gs, rs and xs, because gs, rs is nothing but your output of this block, okay, which is given as an input to the summing point. Then we have another input, reference input for the summing point, that is your xs, and you know that after summing point there is summation of these two inputs. So therefore gs, rs plus xs is your y of s, that is your output. So your output is gs, rs plus xs. Now remember this is equation number 3. Now let us shift this summing point before the block, okay, on the left side of the block. Now if you shift this summing point on left side of the block, or you can say before the block, you shift it with xs, correct? Okay, now let us calculate the output again. Now here at summing point, rs is input, one input, xs is another input. So you get output from this summing point as rs plus xs, which is given as an input to the block. Now since this is an input given to the block, if the transfer function or gain of this block is multiplied with this input, you will get the y of s, that is your output. So y of s will be equal to rs plus xs multiplied by gs. So that means gs plus rs plus gs plus gs into rs plus gs into xs will be your output for this block diagram. Now say this is equation number 3. Now if you compare equation number 3 and 4, you'll again find that the first term is similar but the second term is different. Now the condition is reversed. Okay, here g of s is multiplied with x of s in equation number 4, whereas there is g of s absent in the equation number 3. Now we want to get gs here so that your output gets similar. Okay, now so what we do here, we add a block in between xs and summing point with this value. This is the reciprocal of gs. So it is 1 by g of s block, which is put in between your x of s and summing point. Okay, now let us calculate y of s again. So y of s is dependent on g of s. G of s is dependent on this error signal. This error signal is dependent on the original input and reference input. Okay, now your reference input is xs into this. Okay, Now, what will be your reference input here? It will be x of s divided by g of s. Okay. So, from this summing point, if you get the output, it will be r of s plus this input, and that is x of s divided by g of s. So, you get 1 by g of s or into x of s. That is nothing but x of s divided by g of s. And this error signal will be treated as an input for the block. For this block, this block is having gain g of s, or transfer function is g of s. We'll again multiply this term with this term to get the output. Yes, because gain multiplied by the input, or transfer function multiplied by the input, is equals to your output. Okay, so this is r of s plus x of s divided by g of s multiplied by g of s to both the terms. Now, if you multiply it, you will get g of s multiplied by r of s plus x of s divided by g of s into g of s. So, g of s gets cancelled, the x of s term only remains, and hence your y of s becomes r s g s plus x s. So, you get the similar equation, which is equal to the equation of the original diagram. Remember one thing, whenever we are shifting the summing point after the block, you'll need to add one block with same gain as that of this block. Ye is block ka jo gain rahega, same aise hi gain wala, aise hi transfer function wala block aapko kya karna padega, iske beech mein add karna padega jab bhi aap usko आफ्टर में शिफ्ट करते हैं तो. ओके, एंड जब आप उसको बिफोर में शिफ्ट करते हैं, मतलब पहले ले लेते हैं समिंग पॉइंट को, तो इसका जितना ट्रांसफर फंक्शन है, जितना गेन है, उससे रेसिप्रोकल वाला ब्लॉक आपको क्या करना है, यहाँ पर ऐड करना है. ओके, इसके बीच में ऐड करना है. सो अगर आप बिफोर में समिंग पॉइंट लगा रहे हैं, सो यू विल टेक रेसिप्रोकल. अगर आप आफ्टर में लगा रहे हैं, यू विल टेक द ओरिजिनल वैल्यू ऑफ ब्लॉक. सो दिस इज अबाउट समिंग पॉइंट. Let us consider now block diagram algebra for takeoff point. Takeoff point आपको पता है, you know takeoff point. The takeoff point is nothing but a point from where multiple similar inputs are given to multiple blocks, or you can say a feedback is taken from that point. Yes, as a reference to the input. Yes. Now here the conditions are also same. Shifting takeoff point after the block and shifting takeoff point before the block. Let us consider first shifting takeoff point after the block. So this is your block. Here we have one takeoff point from here, which is taken, which is taken as x's. Okay. Now this x's means this is an input taken from this point and is given to some other, and is given to some other block. Okay. The input taken from this takeoff point is always similar with the input coming in. मतलब ये जो takeoff point में जो input आ रहा है, वहाँ से जो output आएगा, it will also be same. मतलब ये RS और XS क्या है? Same है. साथ ही साथ में RS जो है, वो directly जो आपका GS है, उसमें input बोल के जा रहा है. So there is no change in signal anywhere. यहाँ पर किसी भी तरीके के signal में changes नहीं है. So your RS is equal to XS. Okay. Here you can see XS is equal to RS. Now if you take the output of this figure Y of S is again dependent on the transfer function and the input. Now input to this transfer function or to this block is RS. So your Y of s is equal to g of s multiplied by r of s. Okay. Now let us perform the shifting operation. Let us take the takeoff point after the block. Okay. So we have put the takeoff point after the block. Now if you put the takeoff point after the block, it is now making changes to the diagram. And that changes is nothing but r of s, which is given to g of s as original signal. It remains same. the output of this becomes R of s into g of s. That is also, that also remains same, but the value of your this signal, value of this x of s signal changes, because it is now equal to rs multiplied by gs, because we have taken the takeoff point from this output signal of the block. Okay, now to make it again x of s, what we need to do here is, sorry, if you want to make it again r of s, what we need to do here is, we need to divide the signal by g of s, and to divide this signal by g of s, we need to add one block which says its transfer function is 1 by gs. Now if you calculate the value of x of s here, it will be equal to what? The signal here coming here will be rs into gs, which will be multiplied with this this gain. So rs into gs multiplied by 1 by gs. So 1 by gs, gs gets cancelled. The signal remains only r of s, which is equals to x of s as that of the original value. Okay, so point after takeoff point, अगर आपने after में shift किया, मतलब after the block shift किया, तो आपको इस takeoff point के बीच में, मतलब takeoff point और signal के बीच में क्या करना है, इस block का reciprocal block क्या करना है, लगाना है. Okay, so this is your figure number 2. Again, y of s remains same, it is again r of s into g of s, so there is no impact on the output here. Okay, let us take the second thing, shifting takeoff point before the block. Now the takeoff point is after the block, its value here is xs. Okay, again xs is equals to rs into gs, your value of xs is equals to rs into gs, which is equals to y of s, which is equals to y of s. Now the value of xs is rs into gs. We have to maintain this value of xs when we are shifting it before the block. Now if you shift it before the block, the original value of xs will become, xs will be equal to rs, because we have shifted it. Since we need to maintain it rs into gs, we'll add one block which will be having value g of s, and that will keep the value of x of s similar to the original one. Now if you see the diagram, if you see the converted diagram here, it says rs is coming into this block, that means this rs will be multiplied by this gs, and you will get the value of x of s as equal to rs into gs. Okay, similarly y of s will remain same as rs into gs, so there is no impact on the output, and we have kept the you can say reference input similar to the original one. Okay, just we have added one block and we have shifted the takeoff point before the block. Why we are doing this shifting before the block or after the block? There may time come where you need to simplify this diagram using these operations, because there is chances of having a complex diagram in your examination or in your numerical, and we need to make it more simpler with using these operations, because there it is possible that the previous operations that we have studied, that like a parallel connection, like series connection, like feedback connection, they may not be sufficient enough for reducing the diagram. So we may need to use these operations as well. Okay, so this was all about the shifting of takeoff point and summing point. Till then, we'll meet again in next video. Till then, please stay safe, stay at home, and keep learning. Thank you.